So I'm sitting in front of a very empty kitchen cabinet. I emptied it out last night because I wanted to make a very early start this morning. And then I wanted to sit down and relax for a little bit. But all of these creative things were bubbling around in my head and it really needed to come out. So I got up again and I decorated the whole top of the cabinet. It turned out so lovely. I'm going to show you this whole process in a minute, but first I want to talk about something else. We have a lot of these beautiful branches and I also have them on top of the ladder that hangs above the dining table. If you have seen that video, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But on the right side of this cabinet, there is a wooden support beam and we actually also attached one of these branches to the beam. So my first plan for this branch was to turn it into some sort of a Christmas tree. And I actually started the process of putting all the lights into the branches. But then I took them all out again because the minimalist in me just found it too busy. And I attached the lights behind the support beam in a very straight line to make it look very clean and calm. When I was doing that, I could really notice that my boyfriend was disappointed. He was looking forward to having something resembling a Christmas tree. My boyfriend is going to be home very late tonight. He needs to do all the Christmas shopping together with his sister. And I decided that I'm going to surprise him. I'm going to hang back the lights into the branches and I'm going to decorate the living shit out of this thing. Right now the bottom of this branch is still a little bit... Telephone! There's nobody home! There's nobody here! I'm decorating! I'm not here! Okay, where was I? The bottom of the branch that we attached to the post is still very bare and very empty. So that's why I have this one. I'm going to attach this to the post as well to make it more full and more elaborate and more maximalistic. And then I'm going to show you some of the decorations that I have because I have some very beautiful things. This is a very dark corner. There are no windows around. The only reason why you can see me right now is because I have two huge lights in front of me. And so I am going to use things that are very light and I'm going to use mainly things that are actually white, but they are very beautiful things. So let me show you what I have so far. Because of the bird theme that runs through this whole makeover, I have a lot of these beautiful feathers. They are attached to leather strings, so they will be very easy to attach to the branches. I also have a lot of these beautiful shells left that I used for my bohemian lights. I have a few of these beautiful pieces of wood that I can turn into ornaments. And I have a few of these very cute white little birds. And I have also a very big collection of all kinds of different beads that I can use to make hanging decorations from. First, I'm going to show you what I did last night. After that, I'm going to decorate all the empty shelves that are still in this cabinet. And then we can do our artistic Christmas tree project. There are a lot of different little shelves inside this cabinet. I'm going to decorate them one by one. And after that, I will give you a complete overview. So let's get started with this nature-inspired farmhouse Christmas makeover part 4. Thank you. Besides removing the basket, I also decided to remove the white pot that was over here. It was disappearing a little bit behind the flowers and these branches. And in this case, I decided less was more. This is actually something I love so much. It was in my boyfriend's wood shop for many, many years. When he was building his wood shop, this was something that was left over and he always kept it. I think this is a very personal item to put on top of this cabinet and I absolutely adore it. I also decided to add a little extra glass bottle over here because I had a little bit of space left. I am very happy with how this turned out and I think that we are ready to start decorating some shelves that are inside of this cabinet. How the inside of the shelves turned out, but there were a few things that I wanted to change. First, I think it's a good idea to do the branches and the lights because this is a surprise for my boyfriend and I want this to be finished before he gets home. And after that, I will change a few little things up in the cabinet. by changing those few little things, I do think it looks a lot better. This is still very empty, but right now I really do not have any inspiration about what to put over there. And besides that, I think this also, it could use a little bit of something, but who knows, over time. Overall, I think I'm very happy with how this cabinet looks right now. After doing all of this, I do not really have to say a lot anymore. And this doesn't happen to me a lot. There's just one thing that I do want to say, and this is, thank you so much for watching my video, and I really hope to see you in the next one. Bye!